There's always a lot to expect in the food and beverage industry when autumn comes, and especially when coming to some Japanese restaurant who cares so much about its ingredients. So in this week's program, we bring you to a Japanese kaiseki ryori to try some taste of autumn. Kakomi is located on the second floor of number 9 Jinan Road, a quiet corner of Shintendi. While enjoying a central space in the district, it still provides a quiet escape from the busy streets of Shanghai. Warm lighting and a zen-type feel with Japanese decor and tableware all give the restaurant a quiet and comfortable atmosphere. Today we ordered kaiseki, which is made up of 11 different dishes. Kaiseki is the general term for banquet dishes in Japan. It refers to two kinds of Japanese sets. One matches with tea and the other goes with sake. Today, we will try the latter. Seasonal ingredients are the key to Japanese cuisine, which becomes clear when presented with the kaiseki dishes. The appetizer, crab meat with daises, is one of the best flavors for the season.
Alright, so this is the fried dish in my set menu, and basically I've got two fried items. One, let me show you, that is the maitake tempura, and the other one, that's the urchin katsu. When we're saying tempura is wrapping with flour and then fried it, and katsu is wrapping with breadcrumb and then fried it. We all know the tonkatsu, the fried pork chop, which is widely spread not only in Japan but here in China as well. But in fact, according to the chef, because he's been living in Italy for many years, the katsu cooking style originates from Italy, but later on was spread widely in Japan. We put urchin in the dipping sauce together with black truffle and mushroom to give extra umaminess, so the entire dish will be very, very tasty. Now I'm going to give it a try. I would say the sea urchin katsu is really, really nice because the breadcrumb outside is really crunchy and you can feel the moisturized inside with the seaweed wrapping the sea urchin with different layer of texture and different layer of flavor.
Then it's time for the tuna hand roll. Perilla with the meaty fish meat is the perfect combination.
And here comes my sea crab miso soup. Almost every single Japanese restaurant will make this dish. So in some high standard ones, they put extra seafood into it to add extra umaminess or give some other touch to the entire dish. Why the chef produced this dish is they are using the white miso. They call it saikyo miso. This is very important producing area. White miso is usually more lighter, less salty than the usually ones. And sometimes, especially the saikyo miso in the Kyoto area, it's more sweet. Really, you can feel the sweetness in the entire dish. You've got the crab meat flavor, and together with the miso soup, a very nice combination.
Sashimi is the essence of Japanese cuisine. The daily delivered fish and shrimp reflect the ocean's generous offerings, and you can feel the quality in every bite. The delicate and exquisite layouts of the next two dishes represent the core of Japanese cuisine.
And now we come to the grilled dish in my set menu. And from the very delicate and very decent presentation of this dish, we can clearly see the element of autumn. We've got chestnut, ginkgo, and we've also got a maple leaf, of course, made of carrot. The gelato oyster, very good one, and one of the best from French. Is also grilled with cheese, very Western style. I'll try the oyster first. On the top, we see they've got some dried fish seeds on the top, so that will add extra umaminess to the entire oyster. We always say in Japanese food, ingredients comes first. So the freshness is really very important. Nice. Well, rice is definitely a staple in Japanese cuisine, and when coming to rice, eel rice is definitely another signature dish. But you know which part is the most important part when producing or making eel rice? That is the stock. And it's very similar like the seasoning wine in China. It is produced with the fish head, fish bone, and soy sauce, and will be cooked for a very, very long time to produce the stock. And they will store the stock The longer the storage year is, the thicker and the better the stock is. So, this is a very, very important standard when you are judging if the eel rice is good or not.
The umami and thick slow-cooked eel sauce goes great with the rice, and each bite lingers in flavor.
Finally, we come to the sweet ending and the finale of my dessert. So what's so special about my dessert is this one. That's the salty cheesecake. I think it's like a pudding, but you have to know until you try it. Mmm, it is salty. At first bite, you think it's a little bit strange, but you just can't stop. I like it. And I'll be keep digging in my salty cheesecake. And for you, all of the dishes I had today will be available on the Fine Dining smartphone application. Go online to know more. And for you, you can also scan the QR code on the screen to follow the WeChat to know more about good food and food culture. Bye for now.
Kakomi is one of the luxury Japanese restaurants. Many celebrities come here to enjoy the gorgeous dinner. Once you get into the restaurant, you can tell how the space makes nicely. Usually too luxury or too formal makes us feel tense, but here atmosphere is kind of friendly. Their menu changes once every 40 days. I think that is challenging for Japanese food. To get a good, stable, fresh ingredient, the chef lived in Italy for 3 years before coming to Shanghai, so you can feel the Italian touch from the dishes.